Hi, this is Amy from the Altie store. You might have seen the series of videos that we've been doing where we're showing different ways to wire panels that are mismatched. So different watts, different amps, different volts. And depending on what's different, there's different ways that you should wire it in series or parallel. So you can check out the whole playlist we did showing that. Now, one of the things that we did show was if you do have two different solar panels, two different sizes, the best way to deal with it with charging a single battery bank is for each of them to have their own charge controller. So we did do a video on that. You can check that out. But another option is you could take multiple panels and wire them together to equal the same output as the other mismatched panel. For instance, I have a 100 watt 24 volt panel and I have some 50 watt 12 volt panels. So what I can do is I can wire my two 12 volt panels in series, plus to minus, and then I can wire it in parallel with my 24 volt panel, and I don't have to worry about the lower voltage 12 volt panels pulling that voltage down like it did when I just had a single one. So this is going to show you a great solution. So you can take a look. Right now I just have my 24 volt 100 watt solar panel connected. Got my new handy dandy fancy schmancy meter going on here. So I've got 30.7 volts coming out of that solar panel. Makes sense. The VMP is about 36 volts and it's pretty hot out, so that makes sense. And I have 2.4 amps coming out. Again, that's right around what I'd expect to see. The IMP is 2.78 amps, so that's the maximum power current. So that's generally what you'd see when it's connected. And again, I'm not at perfect angles, I'm not at perfect test conditions, so that seems about right. So what I'm going to do is show you that I've got that 24 volt panel connected through an MPPT charge controller. In this case, it's a Midnight Kid. And it's going to my MK battery, 12 volt battery. So the reason I'm doing with an MPPT is because I'm going 24 volts down to 12 volts. And we've done some videos showing what happens if you use a PWM charge controller in that case too. So you can check that out as well. But so you can see that the output of the charge controller going into my battery is 12.9 volts. And 5.45 amps. So what it did was it took that higher voltage, it dropped it down, and it increased the current to maximize the output. So you can even see on the meter that I've got basically 74 watts going into the charge controller, just about 70 watts coming out. So that makes sense. I've got a little bit of losses through the charge controller. You would expect that with any equipment, you're going to have some losses. So now let's see what I get when I just wire my single 12 volt panel to the same charge controller. Okay, so hold on a sec. All right, now with a single 50 watt 12 volt solar panel, the VMP is 18 volts, so that's maximum power volts, what you'd expect to see with it connected at its maximum output, and 2.78 amps IMP. So that's the same current as that 100 watt 24 volt panel, but it's got the 12 volt panel has got half the voltage, half the volts, same amps. So if we look at what we're reading, we've got 14.8 volts going into the charge controller, 2.56 amps coming out of the panel into the charge controller, and then into the battery, 12.8 volts back to the battery and 2.65 amps. All right, cool. So you can see we've got twice as much volts and so we're going to see what happens if we wire the two solar panels, the two 12 volt solar panels together in series, okay? Okay, so now we have these two 12 volt panels wired in series with the plus to the minus, and we've got those measuring through the charge controller. So we have 28.6 volts going in. That's very similar. And 2.27 amps. Again, very, very similar to that one single panel. So wiring these two together really turned it into basically a 100 watt 24 volt panel. So now let's wire them in parallel. There's a couple different ways you can wire them in parallel. We've done videos on both using a combiner box, which is a great way to make sure you've got breakers between both strings. Or if you've just got a small system that's less than, say, 30 amps, you can use a coupler. So you can check out the videos we did on both of those options. So I'm going to wire the two sets in parallel and we'll see what we get. Okay, so we've got these two solar panels wired in a string of two in series, wired in parallel with a single string of the 24 volt panel. So we've got two parallel strings. One is a string of 2 12 volts and one is a string of 1 24 volts. They both make 24 volts. So now we're going to see that because we wired them in parallel, the volts stay the same. So we look, we're right around 30.8 volts. That's right around what we were getting individually. And we're at 4.47 amps. Now that is twice as much as we were getting with them each on their own. So we've doubled the current by wiring in parallel, kept the voltage the same, except on this string where we doubled this voltage. So if we look at it going through the MPPT charge controller to our 12 volt MK battery, we've got 13 volts going into the battery and 10.14 amps because the MPPT dropped the volts, raised the current, so we're not losing any power. So now we've pretty much doubled our power going into our battery because we were able to wire these efficiently to make them so that the two parallel strings matched each other. I hope this was helpful. If so, give us a like and a share, and be sure to subscribe to our Altie Store channel so we'll notify you when we've got new videos coming out. And don't forget to go to our website at altiestore.com, where we've been making renewable doable since 1999.